Good. 3, 2, 1. Chin up. 3, 2, 1. Go. Work. I'm shooting. Shoot. Woo. Lovely. Oh, my God, girl.
Yo, what's up, everybody? It is your boy, Brandon. What's going on? We are in the studio today. I got my model, Viry, coming through. We're going to get some shots with one of my newest beauty dishes that I have, softbox. Yes, this is a new 24-inch softbox, so really excited to use it. But I just thought this would be a good idea to go over some studio work, man. Maybe some drop a few tutorials, drop a few eggs in there for you guys today. Maybe use a one light with a two light setup, maybe throw some color in there, but and kind of just see how things, how I interact with the model and how studio shooting differs from shooting outside, because it is a totally different monster. So today I'm going to be shooting with the A1, and I love using this lens. This is the 24-70 2.8 Sigma art lens. It's a very versatile lens, especially in the studio. So when I want to get further away, or when I want to get closer, or just work on getting a really good composition, it's really good to use a zoom lens in a studio. That is your first egg. I don't like to really use primes, because, you know, it just doesn't really work for a studio unless I'm using like a macro and I want to get a totally different shot. Other than that, I will always pretty much use a good zoom lens in the studio so I can get the work and get the composition that I need. All right, so comment, like, guys, and subscribe to the channel, because I'm gonna be dropping some eggs today, and I hope you guys enjoy this pretty basic studio shoot with me and the beautiful Viry. Holla at your boy.
Little mama, I've been paper chasing, hoping that you could wait for me. I see that your heart open with some vacancy, and with them petty ass arguments, don't debate with me. Now frankly, I'm feeling like a demon, scheming. I just pulled a six inside a crush, now I'm leaning, beaming. I kill any fuck nigga for you for no reason. I pull up the tip in, are you straight cheese? Now I realize I love hard, die young, get that. Keep a couple racks up on my side just to flip that. If you fucking with my little shawty, I'ma wet that.
Hey, what's up, everybody? All right, we're going to start our photo shoot off here with a one light setup. I do have an Explore 600 overhead with the 24-inch softbox, so I'm just going to angle it slightly down her to get a nice light spread. We're going to see how these shots turned out first, okay? Alright guys, for these next few shots, I want you to see how I direct the model into creating mood and expression in these shots that we're about to take. It's really, really important, because this is kind of what draws your audience in, is the mood you create. All right, guys, continuing with this one light setup. Now, this next shot that you're going to see is going to be kind of similar to the current pose that we just took. However, I'm going to do something that I introduced a while ago called micro posing. This is where I can take a part of the body and slightly move it from the previous pose to create another dynamic shot. And that's what I'm going to get the model to do right now.
Three. So this girl, all the way back. Yeah, there we go. Perfect. Just like that. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. 3, 2, 1.
Okay guys, so for this next shot, what I want to show you is that you can still get some really nice angles and still create pretty unique shots rather than the normal face on shots that you normally create in a studio. So for this next shot, I decided to sit and get a nice angle shot, still keeping the background behind her and still getting nice lighting on her face, but I wanted to create a little bit different dynamic, and this is something that you also can try. Yo, so I hope you guys enjoyed those first set of shots. Those are really amazing. So I hope you guys were able to see basically where the light placement was. I had it nice and angled down on her, so I was getting a really good feel in her face. And it was really lighting up everything that I wanted to do. We didn't do a lot of full body shots because, you know, in the studio, you know, I don't really care about too much about full body, but I want to get poses. I want to get facial features. I want to get expression. And that's what I focus on in the studio. The gray background was absolutely amazing. And as you can possibly see, the distance between where my model was from the background was great. Now, I didn't need a second light. I could have put a light behind her and made a halo effect and a lot of different things. But, you know, just with this type of shot alone, I just use one light. And I just like the way the light spreads and it gets just enough light on the background in order for me to get the shots and stuff that I want to. So I really, really enjoyed that. So now what we're going to do is we're going to take the gray up. We're going to change the backdrop. We're going to bring down my favorite color. I love this nutmeg look. Viry's going to change. She's going to put on an all black dress. Now black on the brown looks absolutely incredible. I love it. So we're going to do that. We're going to change the background and we're going to get some new shots. All right, stay tuned. Okay, guys, so we're changing the background. We're going to go ahead and add a second light here. Now I'm going to go ahead and add my Evolve 200 with a 20-inch softbox. And this is basically just going to put a nice little light on the back of Viry's head. We're going to nice and separate her from the background. And we're going to get some good dynamic shots here. So we're going to keep the mood going. We're going to continue to bring mood into these next set of shots. And I hope you guys like these.
Go work. Shooting. Shoot. Lovely. Oh my God, girl.
Okay, guys, so for these next two shots, I'm going to invoke micro posing again. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring Viry more into the shot. I'm going to bring her body more into the shot. I'm going to bring her more into her audience. So I'm going to basically direct her to give me that appearance and give me that look like she's coming into the audience now. And then we're going to micro pose it. Okay, guys, so I really like this pose and mood that Viry is giving me in these shots. So I'm going to go ahead and micro pose it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make Viry put a little bit more tension in her arms. I'm going to make her put a little bit more tension in her legs, and I'm going to slightly shift her head more into the light so it gives me another good dynamic shot. Check it out. That's freaking fire. I am about to look at this ladder. I don't know how I'm gonna do it, but we're about to use the ladder. Just cuz. Huh? Yeah. All right, so this is what we're gonna do.
I am going to bring a ladder out. I was just kind of looking for stuff to do. So I'm going to get a ladder and I'm going to let Viry like pose on it. And we're going to see how good Viry poses on the ladder. So I'm going to get the shot, but she has a pose with it. So this is pretty cool because this allows you to actually just create stuff instead of like the normal stuff. So when you just actually like throw stuff in there to see how people can actually do and pose with it, it kind of tells you a lot about them and kind of like tells them a lot about themselves. So she has a ladder. So there's a lot of things that you can do with a ladder. Like I posed on a ladder before. So we're going to see how good she does with the ladder. All right. All right. Cool. Come on. So that is how you work. So I'm going to issue a challenge to everybody out there. Definitely. If you guys, I want to see what all you guys get. So all you guys, next time you do a photo shoot, grab a ladder and let's see how you are. I'm talking about lighting, model, poses, expression, everything. Ladder challenge. I am issuing a ladder challenge to all of you guys because I think it's going to be dope. So let me see your ladder poses. Let me see your ladder shots. Let me see what you guys got. Special shout out to my beautiful model, Viry. Cause she's a beast. There you go. Okay, now I'm focusing on her. Yes, yo, you can't now. You got it. So special shout out to her. I'm gonna make sure I put her information in the comments section. Please go follow her because she is still amazing and she's great. And she always comes through when I need her. So until next time, guys, comment, like, and subscribe. Check out the video, check out the other videos, and we'll be back later on. Peace out. We out. Peace.